Welcome back to the Chemical Engineering channel, and in this video we will be solving a numerical which will be focused on the importance of heat exchanger in the process. And in this part we will be understanding the overall concepts which we have learned so far in heat transfer operations. So if you have not subscribed yet, please do subscribe the channel, click the bell icon to get all updates related to this channel. So we have been given a numerical statement that in a dairy plant, milk is pasteurized by hot water supplied by a natural gas furnace. So a natural gas furnace is installed for the pasteurization process of milk, and that has been done by the hot water which is coming from that furnace. The hot water is then discharged after the process to an open flow drain at 80 degrees centigrade at a flow rate of 15 kg per minute. So it's a waste. The plant operates 24 hours a day and 365 days a year. The furnace has an efficiency of 80% and the cost of natural gas is $0.4 per therm, and one therm is equal to 105500 kilojoule. The average temperature of the cold water which is entering the furnace throughout the year is 15 degrees centigrade. So there is a furnace, the cold water is entering at 15 degrees centigrade, the hot water is coming out, helping in the pasteurization of milk, and then is drained out at 80 degrees centigrade, and the total flow rate is 15 kg per minute of drain. The drained hot water cannot be reused in the furnace because it is contaminated during the process. But what we can do, we can obviously preheat the cold water, and that can be done by using that hot water. So what we are going to do in order to save energy, installation of water-to-water heat exchanger for the preheating of the incoming cold water by the drained hot water is proposed in this process. Assuming that heat exchanger recovers 75% of the energy which is currently wasting. Currently, a lot of energy is wasting. So if we are able to recover 75% even energy, it will result in a lot of energy savings in the furnace and lot of money savings in the process. So determine the heat transfer rating of the heat exchanger that needs to be purchased and suggest a suitable type. Also determine the amount of money this heat exchanger will save the company per year from natural gas savings. So obviously you will save natural gas, you will save fuel, you are saving energy, and accordingly the money will be saved. So what we need to do, there will be some assumptions and properties. The number one assumption is that the steady state conditions exist. Number two, the effectiveness of heat exchanger remain constant, which is representing the percentage recovery, 75%, as we have defined in the problem statement. The properties is that assume the CP of water as constant throughout the process as 4.18 kilojoule per kg degree centigrade. So you can see this is the overall representation of this heat exchanger which is proposed to be installed, that the hot water will enter this heat exchanger at 80 degrees centigrade. The cold water which was earlier going directly to the furnace will first pass through this heat exchanger, and the preheated cold water will then go to this furnace. So even if there is a delta of 5 or 10 degrees centigrade, it will result in a lot of saving of that natural gas, and accordingly the energy will be saved, and the energy which is currently wasting due to draining of hot water will be recovered in the process as well. So first we need to calculate that how much maximum energy that can be extracted from this hot water which is currently draining. So that is calculated as Q maximum is equal to MCP TH in minus TC in, as we have seen in our previous case. So Q is equal to this one, 15 kg per minute, but that has been converted to kg per second, 4.18 kilojoule per kg degree centigrade, multiplied by 80 is the inlet temperature of hot side and 15 is the inlet temperature of cold side. So accordingly the Q maximum is calculated as 67.9 kilojoule per second, or that is equal to kilowatt. So we can say that the maximum of 67.9 kilojoule per second of heat that can be recovered from the process. But again, to recover this much heat, you will be needing a high surface area of the process. So accordingly we can say that the existing hot stream water has the potential to supply heat at a rate of 67.9 seconds to the incoming cold water. But for this, very large heat transfer surface area will be required. So what we need to do, we need to extract 75% of it. So what it will be becoming, Q is equal to effectiveness factor multiplied by Q maximum. So 75% multiplied by the total or the maximum amount of heat that can be extracted. So it will be 50.9 kg per second. So that's a reasonable factor, that now we need to extract 50.9 kilojoule per second of the heat from the drained water, and that will be supplied to the incoming water. Now what is the heat exchanger type that will be able to do this? Obviously an ordinary plate or shell and tube exchanger will be good for this purpose, since both sides of the heat exchanger involve the same fluid. As we have seen in Platon frame, it has been said that both of the fluids should be liquid. So liquid to liquid heating and even shell and tube can be used for this purpose as well, because there are flow rates are even same at comparable flow rates and thus comparable heat transfer coefficient. So obviously these two heat exchanger types are the suitable for this process. Now we need to calculate the energy savings from the process, and how that energy savings can be calculated, that first we need to calculate the annual operational hours of this process. And how can be calculated? Obviously we have been given in the problem statement the 24 hours a day plant operation for 365 days. So accordingly the hours per year are 8760, and accordingly energy savings is equal to heat transfer rate multiplied by the operation time. Heat transfer rate is 50.9 kilojoule per second. Operation time is 8760 hours per year multiplying by 3600 second per hour. So converting it, second is cancelled out with second, hour is cancelled out with this hour. So we will get answer in kilojoule per year, and that is energy savings is equal to 1.605 multiplied by 10 raised to power 9 kilojoule per year. So that is our total energy saving from this process. From this energy saving, we can compute the fuel savings, and how that can be calculated, that we have been given the furnace's 80% efficiency. It means that if we input the 100 units of fuel, then accordingly 80 units of the heat is supplied from the furnace. So accordingly, the fuel savings is energy savings divided by the furnace efficiency. Energy savings is calculated from the previous one, 1.605 multiplied by 10 raised to power 9 kilojoule per year divided by the 0.8, which is the furnace efficiency as given in the problem statement, multiplied by one therm divided by the conversion factor, because that kilojoule needs to be converted into therm for the fuel savings, because now we have to calculate the money from it. So this kilojoule will be cancelled out this kilojoule, and accordingly we get the answer in therm per year, and that is equal to 19,020 therms per year. So that's how the fuel savings and energy savings are calculated, and you can see that is a lot of amount that has been recovered, which was earlier wasted in the process. Last, we need to calculate the money savings, and the price for natural gas is $0.4 per therm. So accordingly, the amount of money saved will be money savings is equal to fuel savings multiplied by the price of fuel, and this value, which is calculated from the previous one, multiplied by its price, therm will be cancelled out with this therm, and we will get the money savings of $7,607 per year. So that was the amount which was wasting during process, and that was the overburden in the system. So now what we have done, we have recovered the energy which was going out of the process in the form of the drain water. That drain water energy was recovered, 75% energy was recovered actually, and as a result the cold water was heated, preheated actually, and then it was supplied. Accordingly, the natural gas supply was reduced, the fuel savings, accordingly the money savings and energy savings in the process. So that's the overall representation of using heat exchanger in the process. And again, we can say that is the process to process heat recovery or process integration principles that are applied, that we have minimized the energy requirements, minimized the fuel requirements, we have saved our money from the process, and actually we have enhanced the efficiency of the process. So that's it from this lecture. Thank you so much. Please do watch, like, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Also click on the bell icon to get all updates related to this channel. Till then, it's goodbye. Stay tuned for more videos.